Sign in and navigate the Connecticut Community Colleges WebEx website. Hi everyone. In this video, I'm going to cover how Connecticut Community College faculty and staff sign in to our WebEx website. Let's start with the fact that all Connecticut Community College faculty and staff automatically have a WebEx host account. You don't need to request one. Students and any WebEx meeting attendee do not require an account to attend meetings. To go to the Connecticut Community College website on your computer, just open a web browser, as I've already done, and then enter ctedu.webex.com as the URL in the address bar. Now I'm going to press the Enter key to take me to the website. Once you're at the ctedu.webex.com website, click the Sign In button at the top right. You'll be directed to the CSCU login portal, and you need to log in using your NetID and password, the same credentials as you use to log in to MyComNet. The first time you log in, your WebEx host account is automatically created. There's also a WebEx mobile app to host a meeting or attend meetings. Both hosts and attendees can share content using the mobile app. Now, this is where you are going to start your meeting, but in this video, I'm going to focus on how to navigate to the important things that you need to know once you have logged into ctedu.webex.com before a meeting. So, what's the difference between your personal room and scheduled meetings in WebEx? Right off the bat, notice that in this center display area, I have two choices for my meeting. I can start a meeting, and this will launch my personal room, or I can schedule a meeting. You never have to schedule a meeting if you choose your personal room, because your personal room has its own unique URL that doesn't change. Notice that the unique URL for my personal room is displayed right below my personal room heading, so you can just copy and paste it to share it. Or ask your EdTech director about how to add a link to your WebEx meeting into Blackboard. Faculty who want to use WebEx for virtual office hours often make use of the virtual lobby. You can set your personal room options so that when attendees arrive, you are notified, and they wait in a virtual lobby until you let them in, much like having students wait in an anteroom for their individual advising meeting with you. Now let's consider scheduled meetings. There are certain options available for scheduled meetings that aren't available in personal rooms. You have to enter a meeting topic and a meeting password. Note that under date and time, there's a checkbox for recurrence, which when selected displays different options. To see all the options available for scheduled meetings, click the Show Advanced Options arrow down at the bottom of the form, and then scroll down. From the Scheduling Options section, you can assign co-hosts, set automatic recording, enable breakout sessions, decide on join options in unlocked meetings, require registration, and more. When you're all done, just click Schedule. The meeting will now appear on the meeting list under My Meetings. Sidebar menu options. Now I'm back on the homepage of our WebEx site. Let's look at the sidebar menu over here to the left. First, I'll click on Meetings. Any meetings that you have scheduled will show under the Meetings button. Personal room meetings do not show in your meeting schedule, only scheduled meetings. Now I'll click on Recordings. You can use WebEx to record your lectures either with or without anyone else beside yourself as host in the meeting. The recording will include any content that you share on screen. So WebEx actually doubles as a lecture recording tool in addition to being a video conferencing tool. If you have included student images, videos, audio, or chat in a class meeting recording, these recordings should not be copied in the course from one term to another. This is because there are privacy issues involved and the potential for FERPA violations. Here, you'll see all of your recordings are listed. It can take up to a few hours for a long recording to appear in the list. Use the icons to the right to download an MP4 video of the recording, to share the recording, or to edit or delete a recording. We always recommend that you download your videos to ensure that you have a local copy of the MP4 video file. You can share the meeting recording link in Blackboard, or you could upload a copy of the video to Kaltura in Blackboard. Note that if you want to permanently delete a recording or find recordings that have been shared with you, you have to click this drop-down menu and select the option that you want. Recordings that you had chosen to delete on the previous screen are actually not permanently deleted for 30 days. So if you want to delete them more quickly than that to free up space in your recording queue, you can either select the recordings that you want to permanently delete, or you can select delete all. Now click on the preferences button and then click on each of the tabs to see what options you have available. Note that from the personal room tab, you have the option to customize your personal room URL. This makes it less likely to be hacked because you're changing it from the default format for our system. You can choose to have your room automatically lock and set your virtual lobby notifications and select audio muting and content sharing options. And also, you can assign an alternate host for your personal room if you wish. You can choose whether to enable attendees to unmute themselves or not. And for security purposes, it's probably a good idea to deselect the default to allow anyone to share in your meeting. You can always change that setting within each individual meeting. Be sure to look at all of the options that are available under all of the other tabs as well. Then click Save. Now, let's take a quick look at the options that are available from the drop-down menu under your profile name at the top right. Under My Profile, you can upload a profile picture if you like. Under Contacts, you can click the Add Contacts button and then create contact listings for people that you will later want to add as alternate hosts for your meeting. The Meet Now settings relate to instant meetings, which will open in your personal room. And last but not least, here's where you will find My Reports. Now, don't select the attendance report because this report is specifically for WebEx events rather than for WebEx meetings. These are two different types of sessions. To see meeting attendance, select the usage report. Select the from and to dates and then click Display Report. You can then click the meeting title link and click Export Report. I'm using the Chrome browser, so the export CSV file shows up down at the bottom here. I can show it in the folder, or I could open it and then save it. In another video, I'll show you how to start and host your meeting in your personal room.